Now, you have two laws which were recently passed, and this is why we're going to work some more on this problem. One law provides that all high school students should be taught entrepreneurship and financial literacy by DepEd and all other learning institutions. To be able to teach financial literacy to our pupils, we have to hone the capacities also of our own teachers. And this becomes even more urgent, kasi this is now a law. The other law provides that every second week of November should be declared as a financial literacy week, and DepEd is mandated again to conduct information campaigns, etc., which will also involve the teachers. Yes. Now, to say that financial literacy, to say that one is financially literate, is that insulting? I don't think so. I am financially illiterate. I retired from government as a teacher, as a professor. I don't have savings. I don't have property. And I have been serving University of the Philippines for 50 years. And this is because I did not think about savings. I did not think about investment. I only thought about sharing whatever I had with people I wanted to help. And I never thought about what I would leave behind to my children if anything happens to me. I am financially illiterate. But now there is such a law which provides that we should teach the young kids financial literacy. Right now, many superintendents are already requiring the new teachers who come in to undergo financial literacy courses, part of the induction process na yon, without even an order from us, because at their level, the division superintendents, the regional directors already see what is happening. The issues that are brought up were taken up by 10 people who had placards and so on, calling liling liling sinungaling, liling teliling, and attacking very, very personally. But they do not necessarily represent 674,000 teachers. Pero on their own, these things are already happening, even without an order. Now that there is a law, we have to be more organized about it. Kasi ngayon, ano lang, kiss-to-kiss basis. Oh, whoever wants it, does it, and then requires the people around them to do it. So we have to do it now on a more organized basis. We will have to make it mandatory, perhaps, because we are going to teach the children. The law says the high school students have to be taught financial literacy. So we have to be prepared. We have to prepare the curriculum and so on and so forth. So it might be mandatory.